to mix it, move it, make it. Here we go. B-A-M-B-I-N-O. Bambino.
Let's go, Bambino.
Bambinos, welcome back to today's episode. I hope you've all been enjoying this season so far. So as you all already know, the main topic, the main theme of this season is on the Catechism of the Catholic Church. And today, Bambinos, we have a great episode for you and an important episode. So this episode is about monotheism. So what is monotheism? Well, basically, monotheism is the belief that there is one God, and this is an essential belief in our faith. And of course, you know, for those of you that go to Mass every Sunday, you may remember that sometimes we say the creed, and in this creed we say we believe in one God, or I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. This is a very essential part of our faith. There's one God, one creator for the whole of humanity. So with that, Bambinos, I hope you enjoyed this episode, and over to the Bible verse. Shall we do it together? 1, 2, 3, let's go, Bambinos!
Hi, Bambinos. You're most welcome to a new episode. And this week, we are going to reflect about monotheism. Monotheism means believing in one God. So we all believe in one God and the Holy Trinity, the three persons in one God. So we believe in truth, we have only one God, but three persons, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and all three are one. So that is what we believe. It's a mystery. No one can understand it because God is beyond our understanding. So always remember, our God is one God. We read this word of God, Gospel of Mark, chapter 12, verse 29 and verse 30. Jesus himself said like this. Jesus answered, "The first is, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind and with all your strength." So this is the word of God that you need to learn today, this week. So may God bless you and protect you and keep you safe and help you to believe in one God, that is our Holy Trinity, the Triune God. May God bless you.
So Bambinos, we have just heard the word of God for this week. We are reminded that there is first of all one God, one Lord, and we must love this one God, one Lord with all our heart, all our mind and all our strength. So let us try for this week, let this be our prayer, that we make extra efforts in the things that we do this week and forever to love our God with all that we have. And so now we have a story next. So Bambinos, stay tuned for this story, listen, take it in, absorb all the knowledge, and most importantly, enjoy it. So are you ready, Bambinos? Let's do this one more time together. 3, 2, 1, let's go, Bambinos!
Hello there, Bambinos. Today's episode and this story is so, so fascinating. I absolutely loved learning about it. It was about what is God's name. So I've heard so many different names for God. Elohim, Jehovah, Yahweh, I Am, so many different ones. One of the main ones where everything is based around Moses. So when God came on a bush and then set it on fire and started talking to him. That bush was nothing like the bush behind me. If this bush was set on fire, it would totally burn right to crust. But that one, even after the fire went, it stayed fresh and you could pluck off petals off it. It was so beautiful and wonderful. It was an amazing miracle that God had gave Moses. That's when Moses decided to do what God said. In the Bible, in Exodus chapter 3, verses 13, Moses asks God, "What is your name? The children of Israel ask me, what shall I tell them?" Then God tells him in verse 14 to 15 that, "I am who I am, and thus you shall tell the children of Israel that I am sent you." And in verse 15 it says, "The Lord God, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob has sent me to you. I am." So, Bambinos, did you see it there? Just then, God addressed himself in three different names. Do you know what they were? I do. They were I am who I am, they were I am, and they were also the Lord God. These are all in the Bible. Just through three single verses, God put himself in three different names. How amazing was that? So, which of these is right? All of these is right, Bambinos, because God addressed him in that way. But then, this correct pinpoint one that God gave was I am. So, any of them would be fine for God, but then where did all these other names come from? Yahweh and Jehovah, where are they? So, Bambinos, Yahweh was actually a different word for Lord. So, in the Old Testament, in English, Yahweh was transformed into Lord. But then in Hebrew, Lord was Yahweh. So the first one was Yahweh, and then after that, they made Lord. So that's another one. Four different names for God already. Yahweh, I am who I am, and Lord. How amazing, Bambinos. Then there's also another fact that you need to know for this. Back then, the Hebrews would be so passionate about saying God, and especially the Pharisees. They would think when they say it, they might accidentally take the Lord's name in vain. So instead, they would use the word Adonai. But then, where did Jehovah come from? So there's Adonai as well as Yahweh, and them two both made Jehovah. So what happened was, when Yahweh was spelt, it was spelt YHWH. I always thought there was an A and an E in it, but then there wasn't. So then I got confused and realized that in Adonai, there are vowels. In Yahweh, there aren't vowels. So when they combined Yahweh and Adonai, they somehow got Jehovah. And that is where Jehovah came from. In the Bible, there is also a name Eliham. And that was used 6,200 times in the Bible. And Yahweh was used 6,828 times in the Bible. And Jehovah, who knows how many times Jehovah was used in the Bible. In many TV series and shows, you must have heard these names, and you must have maybe got a little confused on what to use, because I certainly have. In The Chosen, which is a new TV series out, I heard them use Adonai, one of the Pharisees, and then they also used God. It was so cool. But all of this, in short, was I am. And I think that I am was God's particular name, because God, in Exodus chapter 3 verse 15, he says that this is my name forever to all generations. That means God wants forever, for a long period of time. So I think that I am was all of these names in short. Well, Bambinos, I hope you've learnt a lot from this very little session, because you can get so much information, and now you know what to call God, and when people call God, why they call God that name. Bye bye, Bambinos. See you next time with some more interesting facts.
Bambinos, I hope you've all enjoyed that story and learned a lot from it. So now we've had our Bible verse, we've had our story, and now you know what is next. Maybe the best part of Bambino for some of you, it is the art and craft. So Bambinos, get your pens, pencils, paint, whatever you need ready, and get creative. So shall we move on to the art and craft section? We shall. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Bambino.
Bambinos, I'm really happy to see you all again today. Bambinos, today our topic is, what is God's name? But do you know the most famous time God told someone his name? Yes, God told Moses his name on the mountain. And he said to Moses, I am who I am. And that is the time when he told Moses to go to Pharaoh and to tell him to set the Israelites free. And Bambinos, today we're making something to remember how God went to Moses and told him that he is who he is. He said, I am who I am. Bambinos, to make this, you will need a white piece of paper, a black piece of paper. And Bambinos, don't worry if you don't have a black piece of paper. You can just color in a white piece of paper. You will need 4 paint colors, brown, red, orange, and yellow. You'll need a paintbrush, a blue or black pen, glitter, gold paint, and PVA glue, and the scissors. Now let's begin. So Bambinos, you are going to take your white piece of paper and get your red paint, and you are going to draw a flame that looks something like this. First draw an arc at the bottom, and then make it a bit bigger and draw some spikes at the top. Then take your yellow paint and draw the same flame. And on the other side, you're going to take your blue or black marker and draw a branch that looks something like this. Color it in with a brown crayon, or you could use paint. After you've finished painting out your branch, wait for it to dry. Then, Bambinos, with your blue or black marker, you're going to outline your flames. And you will continue outlining your flame. And then, Bambinos, with your scissors, which you have to be safe with, cut out your flames. Then cut out your yellow flame. Then, Bambinos, cut out your brown branch. Then, Bambinos, with your 3 pieces cut out, take another piece of white paper and cut a thin strip on top of it. And then write in your blue or black marker, I am who I am. Then, Bambinos, using your glue, first stick on the red, then stick on the yellow, stick on your branch, then stick on your I am who I am. Then, Bambinos, add dots of glue all around. And then take your gold paint and highlight the edges. Bambinos, look at what we have made. Bambinos, I hope this can remind you how God came to Moses in a burning bush and said, I am who I am. That's it for today. See you next time.
Bambinos, I hope you've all enjoyed that art and crafts. I can see that some of your work is very good. So of course the art and craft is about Moses and the burning bush. And now as we go into the saints section, today is going to be a little bit different because we won't be learning about a saint, but we will be learning about a prophet. So you've just done our art and craft section on the burning bush. Who do you think the prophet we are going to learn about today is? Is it Elijah? No. It is Moses. So today we are going to learn about prophet Moses. So I hope you all once again listen to the saint or prophet Moses and learn from it, understand it, absorb it, and like I said, most importantly, enjoy it. Take care, Bambinos. 3, 2, 1, let's go, Bambinos. Hi, Bambinos. I hope you're enjoying this week's episode. So in this little section, we're going to talk about the prophet Moses. But before we get into that, let's look at the theme for this week, and that's monotheism. I know it sounds like a really big word, but it's really simple. Belief in one God, and that's what we Christians believe in. Now remember, of course, we have the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, but they're all members of one triune God, and that's the one who we worship. And we believe in one God. Let's look at the prophet Moses in a bit of detail. Now, there was a man from Levi who had a son, and when his mother seen the son, she was filled with compassion. She didn't want to let him die. He was a healthy baby boy. So she hid him for as long as she could, for about 3 months. Even then, she didn't let him die. She put him in a papyrus basket and she left him by the reeds at the river Nile. Now his sister, Miriam, was very curious. So she went by the river to see what would happen to him. And just at that time, Pharaoh's daughter came in to bathe. She had seen the papyrus basket and she asked her attendants to go and look and see what it was. And the attendants were filled with compassion. They told her, it's one of the Hebrew babies that's been left here. So Miriam asked Pharaoh's daughter, shall I get one of the Hebrew women to come and nurse him and to look after him? Pharaoh's daughter agreed. So what did Miriam do? She bought the baby's own mother, her own mother, come and look after him and nurse him. And Pharaoh's daughter even paid her to look after her own son. When Moses grew older, his mother brought him back to Pharaoh's daughter, and he was considered the son of Pharaoh's daughter. Now Pharaoh's daughter gave him the name Moses, which means drawn out of the water, which of course, he was drawn out of the river Nile. Moses was already married. He was looking after the flock of his father-in-law. And as he was doing so, he went up to Horeb, the mountain of God. And while he was there, he saw a true wonder. He saw a burning bush, a bush that was on fire, but was not consumed by the flame. Moses was shook. He thought, this is really strange. Let me go a bit closer, have a better look at it. As he was walking towards it, from within the bush itself, God said, Moses, Moses, do not come any closer. This land where you're standing is holy ground. Take off your sandals. It is I, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And at this, Moses hid his face because he was afraid to look at the Lord. God said, I have seen the suffering of my people Israel. I have heard their cries. I will deliver them from the hands of the Egyptians, and I will take them to a land flowing with milk and honey, and you will lead them. You will go back to Pharaoh, and you will say that you will take my people out of Egypt. But what did Moses say? Moses said, who am I, Lord, that I can lead your people out of Israel? But God said, I will be with you, and let this be a sign that once you have led them out of Egypt, you will come back to this very mountain and worship me. Now, that should have been enough for Moses, but his questions didn't stop there. Moses said, suppose I go to the Israelites now, and I say that the God of your fathers has come and appeared to me and will take us out of Egypt. And they asked me, what is his name? What shall I say? And then the Lord told Moses, I am who I am. Tell them that I am has sent me. But again, Moses had to ask his questions. So he asked the Lord, what if they say that the God of our fathers has not appeared to you and they don't believe me? What is that thing in your hand? Moses replied, a staff. And God said, throw the staff on the ground. Moses obeyed. He threw the staff on the ground, and immediately it turned into a snake. Now Moses was afraid and he ran from it, but God said, no, pick up the snake from its tail. And Moses did so. He picked up the tail, and as he did that, the snake turned back into a staff. Now the Lord was prepared for the remaining questions Moses was going to ask, so he did a second miracle. He said, put your hand inside your cloak. Moses did that, and when he took out his hand was leprous. His skin was as white as snow. Now the Lord said, put your hand back. Put his hand back in his cloak, and when he took it out, it was cured. Now the Lord said, if the people don't believe you with the first miracle, they will with the second. And just in case, if they don't believe you with the second miracle, take some water from the river Nile, pour it on dry ground, and it will turn into blood. At the very least, that should have been enough for Moses. But no, Moses asked the Lord, he said, how am I to speak? I'm not eloquent,
I'm slow of speech and slow of tongue. The Lord said, I myself will give you the words, and I will put them in your mouth. Is it not I, the Lord, who gave humans their mouth? Is it not I who make them deaf or mute? Is it not I who give people their sight or make them go blind? Still, this wasn't enough to convince Moses. And Moses said, please, Lord, send someone else. At this, the Lord got angry. And he said, I know your brother Aaron, and he's very good at speaking. So I will reveal the words to you, and you will tell Aaron what to say, and you too will lead Israel out of Egypt. And at this, finally, Moses agreed. So sometime later, Moses and Aaron together went to the Pharaoh and told him that they wanted to take the Israelites out of Egypt. They wanted to go to the wilderness to worship the Lord. But the Lord hardened the heart of Pharaoh, and he didn't let them go. Even after Aaron threw his staff and it turned into a snake, Pharaoh called his own sorcerers and magicians. They all threw their staff onto the floor, and they all turned into snakes. But what happened then? Aaron's staff that turned into a snake ate up all of the other snakes. What happened after that is a series that we now know as the 10 plagues. Every time a plague would occur, Moses would say to Pharaoh that this would happen. Pharaoh would harden his heart. He wouldn't listen. He would suffer the plague. Then he would pray. He would go and cry out to Moses, and he'd say, pray to the Lord, take this plague away from us. Moses would pray. The Lord would have mercy and take the plague away. And then again, Pharaoh would harden his heart and not let the Israelites leave. And this happened again and again and again. There was a plague of infestation of gnats, flies, frogs, insects, locusts, you name it. There was even a plague where the entire Nile turned from water into blood. And then the final plague, the 10th plague, was the most serious of them all. All the firstborn in Egypt died. It was the death of Pharaoh's own firstborn, all the way down to the death of the firstborn of the prisoners in the dungeons, as well as the death of the firstborn of all the livestock and all the animals. But in all this, God protected the Israelites, and there was no crying in the night in their own households. But in the rest of the Egyptians, there was not a single house where there was a death in the family. Now, on that very night, Pharaoh called Moses and Aaron, and he said, take your people out of here. We don't want them anymore. So the Israelites left Egypt, and they took with them gold and silver that were gifted to them by the Egyptians. But when they had left, Pharaoh hardened his heart again, and he took 600 chariots, and he went after the Israelites. Now the Israelites, when they wandered through the desert, they had a pillar of cloud by them in the morning, and at night they had a pillar of fire to give them light so that they could see. And all of a sudden, they turned back, and they seen Pharaoh and his chariots coming after them. And on the front, they had the Red Sea blocking them. And they cried to Moses. They said, why have you brought us here to the desert to die? Were there no graves in Egypt? Do we have to die here? And the Lord said to Moses, don't pray to me. Raise your hand and the seas will part. And that's exactly what happened. Moses raised his hand and his staff, and the seas parted. And there were walls of waters to the left and the right. And the Israelites walked through the Red Sea on dry ground. And as soon as they had crossed, the Egyptians followed them. Now the Lord threw the Egyptians into confusion. He jammed the wheels of their carts and they couldn't move. And immediately the Lord told Moses, raise your hand again. Moses raised his hand and the waters covered the sea. All the Egyptians died, every last one of them. And the Israelites sang praises and they sang glory and honor to the Lord. Even though the Israelites were singing thanks and praise to the Lord, this didn't last for very long. And throughout this sequence in the Bible, we can see that the same series happens over and over again. Now they were thankful to the Lord, yes, but after some time, they would turn away from him. They would seek other gods, they would disobey, they would mourn, they would cry, and this would anger the Lord. He would inflict them with disease or sickness or with pain. Then they would cry. They would ask for mercy. They would ask Moses to pray to the Lord. And of course, the Lord is a merciful God. God is love, and he would deliver them from whatever sicknesses or whatever pain they were experiencing. But of course, that didn't last for very long again, and they sinned yet again. So in this entire sequence, we can see that the Israelites were crying for manna. They were saying that there's no food in the desert. We had pots of meat in Egypt and we'll come out here to die. They prayed, and then the Lord sent heavenly manna down to them so that they could eat. Then they said, we want meat. The Lord sent quail. In another series of events, we can see that they wanted waters because there were no waters at Meribah. The Lord told Moses, call the entire assembly to the rocks at Meribah. And he said, tell the rock to produce water. Now Moses did this, but instead of simply telling the rock to produce water, he took his staff and he struck it twice. And for this, the Lord punished Moses. Although water did come out, he said, you and Aaron will not enter the promised land, although you're leading them there. And many, many years later, when Moses was 120 years old, just as they were about to enter the promised land, the Lord took him up to a mountain and he allowed him to set eyes on the promised land because the Lord is merciful. And as he did that, Moses passed away at the bright old age of 120 years old. He was strong even when he died, and the Lord himself buried him there. Now Moses, even though he had his faults, was a very holy man. He led the people of Israel out of Egypt, out of the hands of slavery, and into the promised land, the land flowing with milk and honey. He went up to Mount Sinai and he brought down the tablets, the 10 commandments, with him. Once when he went up to the mountain, and he came down, the people said, "Your face is so, so radiant. We can't look at it." They were scared to look at Moses. And so he had to cover his face with a veil because of the brightness that was coming out of it. And every time he went back to the Lord, he would remove the veil. In fact, like I said at the beginning, he even came down with Elijah to speak to Jesus during the transfiguration. So my dear Bambino, I hope you've learned a little bit about the Prophet Moses and about monotheism and how it links back to the Prophet Moses. That's all for this week's section. I'll see you next week. Bye Bambino.
Bambinos, I hope you have all learned a lot about Prophet Moses. I hope you're all very inspired by him as well. His courage, you know, to lead the people out of Egypt. And I hope you all have that same, you know, encouragement, bravery to serve our one God. So now Bambinos, it's time for the fun bit. Now we have listened to the story, we've had our Bible verses, we've done the art and craft. So now you know what comes next. It's time for a dance. So Bambino, get off your sofa, get off your chair, and let's get your body moving. 3, 2, 1, let's go Bambino.
Praise the Lord, my lovely Bambinos. Bambinos, today's topic is monotheism. Bambinos, that means that there is only one true God who has created everything. And that is what the Christians believe. And that is 100% truth. That is it. That is the 100% truth. Jesus is the one true God. Yes, God has a name. The name of God is Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Amen. I'm feeling the fire of the Holy Spirit right now. You know something? Okay. Amen. You know, many people, they believe in sun. You know, the sun, they believe that sun is a God. Many people believe that the moon is God. Many people believe that some animals are God. Many people believe that rain is God. Many people believe that water is God. Many people believe that rock is God. Not the Dwayne Johnson, the Rock, WWE. Many people believe maybe even him as God. Many people believe that some human beings are God. Many people believe that certain places, mountains are rocks. But rubbish, all that is rubbish. Only Jesus is God. Jesus is the one true God who has created you, has created me. That is it. Bambinos, you know something? During this lockdown, we have had so many problems. We could not go out to play in our schools and everything. So much of studies, so many problems, you know, all sorts of tensions. I know, Bambinos, you know what we should do? Let us cast our burdens, let us cast our problems unto Jesus. You know why? Because he cares for you. Come on, Bambinos, let's cast our burdens unto Jesus. Here we go, Bambinos.
Higher, 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 love. your burdens unto Jesus, for he cares for you. Cast your burden unto Jesus, for he cares for you. Cast your burdens unto Jesus, for he cares for you.
Bambino, we are now nearing the end of today's episode. We've had our amazing Bible verse. We've had our great story time. We've had an amazing art and craft. And we've learned a lot about Prophet Moses. And all of you look very tired after dancing. So, you've done all of this. And now it's time for our final blessing of the episode. So, Bambinos, let's prepare ourselves to receive this final blessing and continue with the rest of the episode.
Hi Bambinos, we hope and pray that you enjoyed this episode. We welcome your feedback. If you have any feedback to give us, whether you understand or if you don't understand, help us to know that. Inform us through email. May God bless you. And we are going to have the final blessing right now. Abba Father, we pray for all these children of God whom you have attracted to be with us in watching this Bambino program and helping them to know the Bible and the faith in Jesus Christ through the Catechism of the Catholic Church. Bless these children, help them to understand more and more about the faith. May Almighty God bless them and be with them always in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God bless.
Bambinos, we have now come towards the end of our episode. But don't you feel that we have forgotten about something? Because I do. What have we forgotten though? I know. We have forgotten about a quiz. So now, Bambinos, we're going to test you to see how much you have remembered from today's episode. And we're going to have 5 questions. Each question is going to have 4 options. And you have 10 seconds to answer each question. So are you ready, Bambinos? Oh, I hope you are. So, question 1. What is monotheism? A, that there is one God. B, that there is 2 gods. 3, it is a commandment, one of the 10 commandments. Or D, it is to do with monks. What do you think monotheism is? What was that, Bambino? What was the correct answer? The correct answer is A. Monotheism is that there is one God. Question number 2. What was the Bible verse that we have learned for this week? A. Mark chapter 12 verses 29-30. B. Mark chapter 10 verses 12. C. Mark chapter 5 verses 29. Or D, Mark chapter 2, verses 10. Which was the Bible verse that we have learned for this week? And the answer was A, Mark chapter 12, verses 29-30. Question number 3. What 3 colors was used in today's art and craft section for the burning bush? A, black, pink, and green. B, orange, yellow, and purple. C, red, orange, and yellow. Or D, green, white, and blue. What three colors was used in today's episode for the art and craft? So what's the answers, Bambino? It is C, orange, yellow, and red. Question number four. How did God speak to Moses? A, through a burning bush. B, through a sunflower. C, from the sky. Or D, through a human person. How did God speak to Moses? 10 seconds, Bambino. What's the answers then, Bambino? Correct. The answer is A, through a burning bush. Bambinos, it's time for the fifth question, but this is a trivia question, so there'll be no options, so you just need to write your answers straight after I have asked you the question. So the question is this: how many years were the people of God wandering in the wilderness with Moses? 10 seconds, Bambinos. The answer, Bambinos, get ready, is 40 years. The people of God were in the wilderness for 40 years. Well, Bambino, I hope you've all done well. I hope you've all learned a lot from today's episode and I've got all your answers correct. Bambinos, we have now come towards the end of today's episode. I hope you've all learned a lot about Prophet Moses, about monotheism, and I hope today's episode has been a very good episode for all of you. So Bambinos, we are now going to set you a challenge. Your challenge is to create your own burning bush, and we would like you to get your art, the craft that you've made, and send it to this email here down below. And what we will do is, once we receive them, is put them up in the Bambino Treasures section of the episode, so you can see not just your own art and craft, but the art and craft of many other people from around the world who have also done it. So Bambinos, all the best for your challenge, and we hope to see you again for the next episode. God bless.
Bambino!